City of Hope. Though Paris is not known as the City of Hope, in early 1981, it was for me. You see, I was vacationing with a friend from Los Angeles, Alex Payne, who is a reporter for KABC. He suggested that we visit the ABC News Bureau in Paris. Our gracious host was the late Pierre Salinger, the ABC News correspondent at the time and former press secretary to President Kennedy. Well, after a tour of the impressive facilities, we said goodbye, and his last words were, "If you ever need anything while you're in Paris, give me a call. These facilities are yours." Later that day, we happened down a small street, and I spotted a familiar flag. It was the USO, the United Service Organization. Well, as an entertainer, I wondered if there were any shows for American soldiers that I might volunteer my services. We were told that while there were no current productions, they were busy planning for the biggest gala ever, celebrating the 50th anniversary of the USO worldwide. It was to be held at the American Ambassador's Palace, with invitations going out to celebrities and VIPs around the world. I thought it wouldn't hurt to ask the director if they had chosen a master of ceremonies for this prestigious event. A look of disappointment came over his face as they explained that they did have a well-known star booked for the job, but found out that morning that he would not be able to make the trip to Paris. I told him about my years of experience in hosting events, and he asked if I happened to have any materials. As luck would have it, I had a complete portfolio, including video, that I was bringing to a New York agent on my way back to L.A. When I offered to run over to the hotel a few blocks away, he explained that there was no VCR at the USO. It was then that I remembered the words I had heard earlier and said, "That's not a problem. I'll call our friend Pierre Salinger at ABC. We can watch the video there." I could tell he was impressed. A few hours later, I was formally invited to return to Paris in a couple of months to host this magnificent affair. That July, when I came back, it was not as a tourist, but as the guest of the mayor of Paris, attending several events leading up to the celebration. A few days before the event, it was obvious that the volunteers on the committee, while hard workers, were not experienced in putting on such a grand production. I offered to help, and they seemed relieved. Even though the palace had several large rooms, none were big enough for the show and the audience, so I suggested using the Grand Terrace as the stage and the garden for our guests. The setting was perfect as we performed under the stars, and seated on an oversized pillow on the stairs leading to the garden was our guest of honor, one of the greatest female stars of all time, Her Serene Highness Princess Grace of Monaco, the late Grace Kelly. As I presented my comedy and introduced each world-class performer, I would glance over to see her smiling face and wondered if this was all a dream. Everything about the evening was exquisite, including the door prizes, like a trip to Tel Aviv, and gold cufflinks donated by President Reagan. The princess seemed to be having such a good time that I decided to ask her to help pick the winning names. She was delighted, but upon reaching into the basket to read the first ticket, announced, "Oh dear, I forgot my glasses." I said, "Ladies and gentlemen, Mrs. Magoo." She was truly amused, and it was obvious that royalty had not altered her sense of humor. It was indeed a night to remember. I've often thought that none of this would have taken place had I not seen the red, white, and blue USO banner. And what if the original MC had been able to make it? All this had happened because I'd recognized a flag and walked into an opportunity of a lifetime. An opportunity made possible by Hope. Bob Hope.